All right, this is John Kohler with GrowingYourGreens.com. I have another exciting garden update for you. So I'm here, and after getting back from a trip, you know, there's a lot of things to do at the garden. And a question you might often ask yourself is, hey, John, what do you do in the garden every day? Or what should I be doing in the garden? So what we're going to do in this episode today is kind of explain to you my thought process on the process I go through on what I'm going to do in the garden. Whether it's a day I come back and there's a lot to do because maybe weeds have been growing, things have been going to seed, and things have basically been unkept while I was away. Or, you know, on a day where we're all up to speed and caught up and there's no weeds in the garden. I wish there was days like that. But in any case, that's what this episode is going to be about. Before we move on, I want to kind of show you this front bed. I think this bed looks really beautiful. Now, once again, this is an all edible raised bed. You can see in the front here, we have all these different colored violas. They've grown in really nice and lush. Now, I want to remind you, all these flowers you see here and all the different colors are absolutely edible and they're absolutely delicious. So you could dress up a salad with them, and you could even eat the leaves too. The leaves of the violas are also edible and they have a nice, really nice flavor too. Behind the violas, we have spinach growing. So we did plant this spinach, you know, earlier in the year, late in the winter. And now you can see it's all filled in. So this is just an amazing kind of view, like artistic view almost, with the flowers on the edge and the spinach all in the middle. Then behind it, we had the kale. It's growing, a dinosaur kale. And this kind of grow out too much. So you can see here, the spinach over on this side looks really nice and lush and bountiful, but you can see this kale literally dumped over on the spinach here. And if we kind of lift this up carefully, you can see the spinach underneath here that didn't get any sun was literally, it was stunted because it just wasn't getting any sun. So the thing we're gonna probably do is we're gonna cut this back because I don't really need a dinosaur kale seeds. There's a lot of seeds on here. We're gonna save some that's not necessarily blocking the sun to some of these plants. So in the beginning of every day, I like to just come out to the garden and walk my garden. So whether you have a full-on front yard set up like this and also have stuff in the backyard, or you have a 4x4 raised bed, you know, you should maybe check it every once in a while, at least every day, every other day or something, depending on how much time you have, and just see what's going on. You know, see if there's things overgrown that's like this, and this could have been better staked up so it didn't fall over and shade out plants. You also want to look for any, you know, insects or disease. So in this case, there's no insects on here. I see some aphids over on some of these right here. Here's some aphids. So you definitely want to be handling aphids. That's you're definitely high on the priority list, because if you don't get these guys now and get them off site, they'll basically spread and multiply, and then you'll have a much bigger problem. So it's definitely wise to you know, deal with your bug problem. So it looks like we got a lot of weed pulling, aphid clipping. And the other thing that's important for me right now is, because we are getting into the summer season, we need to definitely get planted out for summer. I probably should have done this about 2 weeks ago to get all the tomatoes and all the summer crops in place so they could start growing and start producing sooner rather than later. So we really have to start clearing out some of the beds that we have growing from the winter time and start putting in some summer crops. So I won't be able to save all the seeds that I want to, but I may let certain plants, you know, produce some seeds that I will end up saving. So let's walk around the garden and I'll show you what we're gonna do today. So this is my second bed, and there's a few things that actually we need to do in this bed. I guess the end goal is that this bed will basically get cleared out, and I'm probably gonna end up planting some kind of summer crop in here, most likely some peppers, since I love peppers so much and they are expensive to buy. So once again, I encourage everybody to grow what is easy to grow but expensive to buy. So carrots are fairly easy to grow, but they're also really cheap to buy. So unless you have a lot of space, you don't want to necessarily dedicate a lot of space to growing carrots. You might want to grow tomatoes that cost more money to buy, but are fairly easy to grow, and actually they yield a lot per plant, whereas one carrot plant will yield like one root to eat. But in this bed, we have a few things going on. First off, I'd like to point out this guy. We have some white powdery mildew, since we did get kind of warm and then it also kind of rainy and haily lately. So these plants with white powdery mildew, once again a disease, they need to get going, because we don't want this to spread to anything else in the garden. This stuff right here is called frisée, and if you let frisée get really big, it looks like this. And this is absolutely still edible, but it actually gets a lot more bitter than it is when it's younger. So this is optimally to be eaten when it's younger. Because it is larger now, we're probably just gonna pull it and compost it, you know, although you still could eat it if you desired. But here it is right here, another big frisée plant going to flower, and that's like a hardcore green if you like hardcore greens. So, you know, gardening is really fun because you never know what you're going to get. If you plant a little frisée plant, you see frisée at the store for sale, you see what they look like. But when they get, you know, they go to flower and seed, man, they get tall. This is at least 3 feet tall. Behind me here, we have the Brussels sprouts that have also gone to flower. And here's some of the Brussels sprout flowers and seed, and you can see all the little seed pods. But besides the seed pods, this has been a big attractant for the aphids. I don't know if you could see that on the camera there, but these stalks are literally just all gray, and the little gray dots, those are all aphids. So we immediately have to pull these up so that the aphids don't spread to other plants in the garden. Plus, you know, we're gonna be replanting this area anyway. All right, so as you can see, we're sitting in my strawberry bed, and this strawberry bed is totally lush. There's like so many strawberries. All you see if you look down here, I mean, it's just solid red. So that's another thing that needs to really get done today, is that we need to really harvest all these strawberries, and they need to get eaten. So guess what I'm eating for lunch today? I'm eating a lot of strawberry smoothie, actually. So that's gonna be really good. So we gotta harvest these. So, you know, as you walk around, you'll see things that need to get harvested and things that I'll need to get done. My primary focus on growing everything here is for one reason, is to grow food for myself. And I'm not screwing around when doing that. You know, I'm not a hobbyist. I'm here to do food production at a residential scale to feed myself, basically, and feed myself the highest quality food. So hopefully all you guys out there, you know, want to make a significant impact in your diets and grow a significant portion of the foods, you know, yourselves instead of buying them. So one of the main things I'm focused on as I'm walking around the garden is, you know, what can I plant? What more can grow? How can I better and more effectively use the space that I have to grow more food? So if I see empty spots, I'll think about what I could plant in there that'll do well in that area. You know, I'll think about what areas need to get replanted with new crops that are gonna go in, for example, for the summer season. You know, so I'm always thinking about production. How can I maximize production? How can I help the plants produce more, whether it's fertilizing them, making sure they're getting water, and also the general health of the plants. Another thing that's very important to me is if a plant is not healthy, we need to stop what we're doing, basically, and make sure it's healthy and make sure it's survival by, you know, removing bugs, removing diseases, or whatever it is. Let's go over to another plant that actually is having some challenge right now, and we're gonna see how we can help it out. So another thing going on in the garden are these guys. This is called mallow. And once again, this is commonly known as a weed, but you could also eat these. I like to especially eat the small leaves. So some may consider this like a famine food, but I like to actually pick a couple leaves and put it in my salad every night. But the problem this one is having is right down here. You can see these top leaves are really nice and lush. They look really healthy. But if we just go a little bit down, oh, and check it out. That's a little baby ladybug before it turns into a ladybug. That's really cool. So let's go to a different leaf. So the problem this plant is having here is, say this leaf looks really nice, and these leaves actually get really big. I mean, there's my hand. I mean, it's as huge as my hand. Once again, this is all edible. Just pick it and eat it raw. But the problem is you can see all these yellow spots on it, and that's definitely not a good thing. We could turn this over and take a look. Looks even worse. Looks like it has some kind of disease, and it does. You're right. This one's actually called rust. So these leaves are getting rusted. It's a fungus disease. So we want to basically pick off all the leaves that have the rust. You know, and some are worse than others. I mean, here's one right here, lots of rust. We got to pick all these off because this rust will spread from one leaf to another. So we're basically going to go to this plant and pick off all the leaves with rust, compost, and get them off-site, get them off property so that this rust can no longer spread to, you know, any other mallows on property or any other plants that may be affected with the rust. So another thing happening or growing on is this stuff. This is the bronze fennel. So you guys that are my long-term viewers may have seen my other episode with the bronze fennel. This is some really cool stuff. You could eat it. Nice licorice flavor. Seeds are good for seasonings. But this stuff just takes off, grows so crazy when the weather's right, and it's literally blocking the pathway. So what we're gonna have to do is tie this up. So another thing, you know, often we'll do will be like tying and staking up and pruning plants if needed. Because, you know, you want to be able to walk through here, you want it to look neat and orderly. Well, if that's your goal, especially if it's in your front yard. So we're gonna tie this up, you know, so basically give me a nice walkway back again instead of having it all look all wild. unless you like that wild look.
So this is the pepper bed we planted out a couple weeks ago. Now some of the plant peppers are actually doing fine and some of them aren't looking so hot. And you know, they're a little bit yellow. So if you have the problem with the yellow peppers, that may be a problem with your soil, but it might be other problems too. But this happened to me last year when we planted the peppers and they were kind of a little bit yellow. So what we did was we used basically something like this. This stuff is actually General Organics Biomarine Cold Processed Fish. So what that basically is, it's like a fish emulsion. So it's high in nitrogen. So we'll basically mix some of this up with water and water all these plants with it to give it some extra nitrogen to help it get going. Maybe it's in transplant shock, or you know, maybe there's just not enough nitrogen in the soil. Because I always recommend that people try to do as natural as possible using a lot of organic compost, rock dust, and other things to the soil. But sometimes you need that little extra boost. Now I don't recommend putting in that little extra boost always. I only recommend putting in that extra boost if you need it, such as in this case when the plants are giving us a signal that something's going on, then we need to take some action to see if we could help them to get healthier. And if this works, great, and if not, then we're gonna try something else until we do something else that's gonna work so that they can get healthier. So we're gonna try this today, and that's another task on the to-do list. Let's keep moving around and learn about some more things that's gonna be going on in the garden today. So this is a tree collard bed, and there's always tree collard leafing to do, you know, pulling off leaves that aren't alive and they drop on the ground because they produce so much food to eat. But I want to show you guys this. These are tree collard flowers. These are really rare that you would ever see these. And this is the first time I've seen the tree collard flowers. And you can see here the tree collard seed pods right here. So we're gonna definitely let these guys ripen up and we're gonna get some tree collard seeds. So this is, once again, this is the purple variety of the tree collards. And then down below here, we have the standard green variety that seems to seed more often than the purple variety. So I don't really even know if these are true tree collards, if they're actually going to seed. So we're gonna actually cut this one down after the seeds are mature, and we're gonna save these seeds and then see if this tree collard plant continues to grow. So the next thing we have to do today, or really soon, is this. This is my overgrown herb bed. So if you believe it or not, this guy right here is some parsley that is now flowering. It's like 3 feet tall. Pretty amazing. And then over in this area here are all the herbs that I've grown since last year. So here's some oregano going to flower. And you know, once again, you can eat the oregano flowers. They have a nice intense like oregano flavor, but they're a little bit sweet. And you know, there's just a little tiny flower. Most people never get to eat the oregano flowers. But the goal is we need to plant all these herbs that you just saw me get at the Morning Sun Herb Farm. We need to plant these in this bed or somewhere else, or at least make room for planting some things. So, you know, this year I've learned that some things like oregano, and I kind of knew this was going to happen, did really well and grew all year, and it's gotten so big, you know, you don't want to plant it in your raised bed because it literally took over. And it's supposed to be an herb bed with all different kinds of herbs, unless you plant them and clip them back as you need them and don't let them get too large. But I tend to like let things grow. So we're gonna plant this in a container and transplant all some of these big things in containers so we have space to plant some of our smaller stuff. So this is yet another project we have growing on here. So when I was gone, I had a friend plant some of these kakai pumpkins. So once again, I'll have an episode soon on these kakai pumpkins. These kakai pumpkins are basically pumpkins that grow hullless seeds. So that means when you open the pumpkin up, it'll be a green seed. There won't be that white shell coating that's really hard. So you could literally eat the seeds without having to shell them. They're really delicious, and also they last long. So I actually have some pumpkins from last season, you know, that still's good for this season. So we're gonna open one up in an upcoming episode for you guys. But we already had cleared this area to plant the new stuff. We planted the kakai pumpkins going up the trellis. You need to be judicious at staking them. So like we just covered earlier, so every day you might wanna come by and, you know, take a leaf and train it up against the trellis so it grows up, because these guys aren't necessarily you know, like to grow vertical unless you train them to do so, because they'll just sprawl out all over. The other thing is we planted some things down here in the ground, and I always like to plant things at the height of the raised bed. This area was a little bit low, so what happened was we planted these on a mound at the height I wanted to. So what we're gonna come back in now and do is put some extra compost in or soil to raise up the level the same height as the mounds. Now, if you don't raise up the height fairly soon after you grow things on the mounds, after time and after watering, these mounds will basically dissolve and it'll all level out. So you'll actually be planting in a lower spot than you probably would have. So that's another critical thing we need to do, is bring the compost out to raise up all the levels of the ground so we could have the most compost available, which is basically bringing in the nutrition for the plants. So more and new compost is definitely better for the plants. So let's move on and show you one more thing we're doing here in the garden today. So this is the broccoli patch that won't go away. I did a previous episode showing we were clipping all this back so that we could replant new stuff, but we got lazy. We clipped it all back and never really pulled anything. But you can see here now the broccoli is reshooting again. We got more broccoli to eat, and also we have, even better than the broccoli, all the luscious leaves. So all these leaves of the broccoli plant, they're really delicious. You could eat them just like collards or kale. You could eat them raw. There's no need even to cook them up. And so we have all this broccoli going on. Some of it's actually even going to flower, and the broccoli flowers are edible and quite nice. There's some aphids going on in here too. So what we need to do today, once and for all, we need to take care of this broccoli. So we're gonna harvest all the green leaves. We're either gonna juice them or make some dehydrated broccoli leaf chips. We're gonna harvest the broccoli and either juice them or actually eat those for dinner. And then we'll have this bed empty once and for all, and finally, the tomatoes will be able to go in here. So hopefully after watching this episode, you're kind of more aware of what I think about when I walk through the garden every day and, you know, what I need to do in the garden. I basically walk around and check for the health of the plants, see if there's any empty spaces I could utilize to grow more plants, you know, and see what needs to come out, what needs to get replaced, if anything. Also, if there's disease or bugs, those need to be handled as soon as possible so that they don't spread and then affect more of your garden. Also harvesting and using the food you're already growing instead of it letting it rot on the vine or going bad or getting eaten by bugs. So harvesting is also another big part of that. So hopefully you've had fun walking around my garden with me. So once again, this is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. We'll see you next time, and keep on growing.